In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My friends, as we gather around this holy altar to unite our lives to that of Jesus Christ, let us first call to mind our sins and ask that our Lord Jesus Christ meet us in our deepest needs. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, that in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, shout with joy for Jacob, exult at the head of the nations, proclaim your praise and say, the Lord has delivered his people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them back from the land of the north. I will gather them from the ends of the world with the blind and the lame in their midst, the mothers and those with child. They shall return as an immense throng. They departed in tears, but I will console them and guide them. I will lead them to brooks of water on a level road so that none shall stumble. For I am a father to Israel, Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men and made their representative before God to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He is able to deal patiently with the ignorant and the erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you," just as he says in another place, You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a sizable crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind man, the son of Timaeus, sat by the roadside begging. On hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, Son of David, have pity on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent, but he kept calling out all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take courage, get up. Jesus is calling you." And he threw aside his coat and sprang up, and he came to Jesus. And Jesus said to him in reply, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man replied to him, "Master, I want to see." And Jesus told him, "Go on your way. Your faith has saved you." Immediately, he received his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
In today's gospel reading, we encounter Bartimaeus, a blind man who is healed by Christ. Now, today's gospel reading is very important because embedded within it is a process that can help us develop a better relationship with God, especially during our times of need. If we do call out to Jesus, he will hear us. Jesus heard Bartimaeus, even though Bartimaeus was considered, because of his disability, one of the least of the society at the time of Jesus. Jesus heard Bartimaeus, even though he was hidden by the vast crowd that had come to see Jesus. Like Bartimaeus, Jesus will hear you when you call to him, whether you are a person of some importance or whether you are someone who feels rejected and unnoticed by society. Jesus will hear you, even if no one else cares that you exist. When we call out to Jesus, there is no doubt that he will respond. It may not be the first time we call or second, but Jesus will respond just as he did to Bartimaeus. We don't know how many times in his life that Bartimaeus called out to be God to be healed. All we are privileged to know is the number of times that he called out in this gospel passage. Despite this, Bartimaeus did not get discouraged. When Jesus didn't respond right away, he didn't stop calling, and neither should we. Even if those people ridicule Bartimaeus, even if other people ridicule us, Bartimaeus knew that Jesus was his last and best hope, and like Bartimaeus, we should never give up calling to God. It is also important that we pay attention to the way that Bartimaeus called Jesus. Remember, he said, "Jesus, Son of David, have pity on me." Now, what does this mean? Before asking God for help, he praised Jesus and recognized him as the Messiah, the Son of God. This is important because it recognized the type of relationship that Bartimaeus acknowledged to God. Before asking Jesus for help, he notified God and everyone else there that Jesus was his Lord and Master, that Jesus was God. And it was only after recognizing the divinity of Jesus in front of everyone in Jericho on that day that Bartimaeus asked Jesus to have pity on him. When we pray to God, it's important that we keep in mind just who and what Jesus is. Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus is the omnipotent and all-powerful God. It's because Jesus was God that Bartimaeus dared to ask Jesus to be healed. Likewise, because of the divinity of Christ, that's the reason why we believe that Jesus can and will hear us. So an important step before asking Jesus for something that we want is acknowledging to Jesus his place in our life, that he is our God, our Savior. When Jesus heard Bartimaeus, he stopped, and then he called his followers to call Bartimaeus to him. Now, Jesus could have walked Bartimaeus himself. Might have been easier to do that. But it was important to Jesus that Bartimaeus made the effort to come to him, even though he was disabled. For his part, when asked, Bartimaeus did this with abandon. He left behind everything he had, his cloak, the money he had collected, everything, because his faith told him that Jesus could offer him so much more than the existence, that dreary existence that he had. The same applies to us. When Jesus hears us calling, he may initially respond by calling to us to move closer to him, just as he called Bartimaeus to move closer. Now, sometimes Jesus reaches out to us personally in our prayers, but most of the time, he sends someone else, some other Christian, to invite us to become closer to God. And when we call out to God for help, an important part of the process is to pay attention, to listen and see with their spiritual ears and eyes for this response of Jesus. And it's just as important for us to be willing to leave something behind, something that is in our life to create the time and the space to respond to call of Jesus. No matter how sad or depressed or lost that we may be, it's important that we make the effort to move closer to Jesus. Now, this might mean finding a quiet place at your home, or it might mean coming to church to spend some time in front of Jesus in the tabernacle. It's for this reason that our church and most other churches are unlocked during the day, because Father Jake knows that Jesus does call to us in his time and in place. And when he does, it's important that we have the ability and the place to respond. And so during the day, we keep this church open for you. When Bartimaeus finally stands in front of Jesus, something interesting happens. Jesus asks him, "What do you want of me?" Now, some of us might say, "Well, he wants to see," but it was important that Jesus asked this question because Bartimaeus was a beggar. Maybe he just wanted some gold or some silver, but Bartimaeus had waited his whole life for this opportunity, and so he decides to risk it all and to ask Jesus, who was his last chance for a normal life, if he could see. When asking God for something, it's important that we think it over before asking. We should make sure that what we ask for is truly what we need and is what is best. Many times we don't really know what we need. We just know that we need something. And in those times, we are better off merely asking God to take control and lead us to what is best in our lives. Finally, it is important that we have faith in God. We must believe that God can help us, just as Bartimaeus believed that Jesus could heal him. This faith in God and faith in God's mercy is vital. In miracle after miracle in the gospel, what does Jesus say after the healing? He says, "Your faith has saved you." So what does that mean? Well, Jesus is not saying that Bartimaeus healed himself. What Jesus is saying, though, is that the faith of Bartimaeus played an important role in his healing. In just such a way, our faith in God is an important part of our healing process, of our process of asking for something. And as such, it's important that it's not minimalized. Faith and hope is important. Faith and hope are divine gifts from God that are sent by God so that to sustain us and maintain us. As Catholics, we may at one time or another feel overwhelmed or depressed or powerless, and it is not sinful to feel this way. However, as Catholics, we should never despair. We should never believe that our problems are beyond the power of God to help, because when we do so, we deny the very scope of the power of God. God gives us faith and hope so that even in our darkest times, we can believe with a certainty of our faith. We can have hope that better days are ahead. Despite the indignity of his life as a beggar, and despite being blind and being subjected to ridicule by those around him, Bartimaeus never lost hope. He never lost faith in God, and that led to his healing. And it's important that we don't lose our faith in God. When Bartimaeus had the opportunity to reach out to Jesus, he would not be silenced. He would not be ignored. Through the divine graces of faith and hope, he repeatedly dared to call out to God, even in the face of ridicule, so that he could be saved. God can and will help us, just as he helped Bartimaeus. So it's important that we keep our spiritual eyes and ears open. Like Bartimaeus, it's important, remember, to call out to God and believe in our hearts that God will hear us. And then it's important to listen for that call, that initial call from Jesus. And when Jesus responds to our calls, it's vital that we move closer to Jesus through prayer. And then it's important that we honor Jesus as God before we tell him what we want of him. Finally, we must open ourselves up to the will of the Lord on his time schedule and not on ours. Remember, Bartimaeus probably called for healing his whole life. Finally, we need to have faith in the one true God, that Jesus will help us and will remain with us no matter what happens. God knows as humans that we are not always happy as we go about our lives. Jesus was human. He experienced that. He saw that in others. He knows that sometimes we'll be sad and angry and depressed. And because of this, God sends us the graces of faith and hope to sustain us during these times. Jesus knows that it is only through him that we can be saved. And Jesus patiently waits for your call.
Together now, let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead,
and
his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Like Bartimaeus the blind man, let us cry out in our need to our Lord that he may hear and take pity on us.
That all clergy may be strengthened and edified by the power, by the prayers of the church throughout the world, we pray to the Lord. That God may protect people and communities in exile due to war, poverty, or oppression. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus' healing may touch those who are blind or visually impaired. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the prayers of the Mother of God may strengthen all mothers to follow her example of welcoming new life despite fear, doubt, and uncertainty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may form us into a welcoming and supportive community for all who seek God's way. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the benefactors of this Mass, we pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, all the intentions listed in our book of prayers, and for all of our own intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Father, you have done great things for us. Deliver us from our need by granting us what we ask. We make this prayer as we make all prayers. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father, the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, who you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore,
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
At this time you can make your spiritual communion at home.
The storm.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
This Sunday we have this evening, we have our fourth Ignite Sunday at 4:30 p.m. with a Mass followed by a meal and programming. Tonight's topic is, what is hope and why do we need it? If you are interested in attending or have any questions, please contact the parish office or go to our website, www.olvjfk.com. The OLV Christmas Rummage Sale is going to be next Saturday, October 30th, from 8 to 6 p.m., and then Sunday, October 31st, from 7 to 1 p.m. in the church gathering space. If you have any questions, again, you can contact the parish office. And also, we'll be having a special event Saturday, November 6th, starting at 8:30 a.m., called Parishioners Helping Parishioners. Every year, parishioners volunteer to help rake leaves, clean up yards, and just to be of service to our fellow parishioner. Again, if you'd like to sign up for this or have more questions, call the parish office. And since I keep mentioning that, the number is 391-4245. With that, I hope everyone has a blessed week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Is most recognized for Halloween costumes and trick-or-treating for bags of candy. So it should be no surprise that October is also National Dental Hygiene Month. The entire month is dedicated to promoting healthy mouth, gums, and teeth so we can enjoy the candy at the end of the month. Here are five fun facts about dental hygiene. The Fones School of Dental Hygiene opened in 1913 as the first in the nation. The first bristle toothbrushes were introduced in 1948. Before that, animal hairs were used most widely. Tooth enamel is the strongest substance in the human body. Tooth decay is the second largest disease population in the US. And regular dental cleanings can prevent heart attacks. National Dental Hygiene Month is very important for adults and children to understand and participate in for these reasons. Number one, it encourages you to increase your dental health to keep the bacteria away and decrease the risk of developing tooth decay, gum disease, and even tooth loss. Another reason is because it celebrates Dental Hygienist Month. There are over 200,000 dental hygienists keeping our mouths happy and healthy. Lastly, this month is a great annual reminder to regularly upgrade your toothbrush. Most dentists recommend a soft bristle brush, but check with your dentist to see what type he recommends for you. Dental hygiene may lead to a healthy smile by brushing, using a soft brush and fluoride toothpaste at least twice a day, flossing between teeth every day to remove plaque, rinsing with antimicrobial mouthwashes, chewing with sugar-free gum to help produce saliva, which fights cavities, neutralizes plaque, strengthens enamel, and cleans food debris from your teeth. Drinking plenty of water to reduce stickiness and the acidity in your mouth, and limiting sugary, sticky, and acidic foods. And last, seeing your dentist for cleanings and prophylaxis at least twice a year. Avoid these bad habits to promote proper dental care by treating your teeth not like tools, smoking, biting your fingernails, and chewing on ice. Social media posts shared for dental hygiene may show proper brushing techniques, how to floss, benefits of sealants, how to choose a toothpaste and mouthwash, good snacks and bad snacks, how to fluoride treatments benefit adults and children, and what to do about bad breath. Several reasons to call the dentist between visits include tooth pain and sensitivity, bleeding gums, swelling, jaw cracking or popping. Your oral health may be linked to stroke, heart disease, diabetes, and pregnancy complications. Common consequences of poor care are cavities, gingivitis, periodontitis, and oral cancers. Remember, oral health is essential to general health and well-being, and it's never too early to start. Also, oral health can be considered an important part of prenatal care. Some ideas for special offers during October are complimentary adult fluoride treatments, free electric toothbrushes for new patients, and health certificates for patients to share with family or friends. Thank you for your attention, and stay safe until we meet again at the Cozy Corner.